Hey there, guys. Welcome back to another episode of Kavinsky's Tutorials, a very short one. So I just want to look at the update that Skulptur by Bram Bos and Hainbach has had. So I reviewed this app about a month and a half ago, a really nice filterbank. But it's got even better now because it now has Midi out, right? So cool. But it's not perfect, and I'm going to explain in a minute why not. So this is just fantastic because I now have, you know, a bunch of sliders here loaded as an AUV in AUV3 inside an app like AUM. All adjustable window and everything. So, you know, a few days ago I did a walkthrough of strips by sqsl, and that is a great MIDI controller for iPad, but it's standalone, it's not AUV3. So it's brilliant to have something like this AUV3. I'm just so pleased about this, and I will definitely use it a lot. But the main limitation I want to say is that if we go into this cycles page here, which is basically doing LFO stuff, it's very limited how useful it is, and I'll show you why. Because here we can set a bass level, but we can't cap the upper limit. And for this particular thing that I'm using here, I really don't want all the sliders going up to the same level at the same time, because it just gets too much of a crunchy and distorted sound that I don't want. And even though I can limit I can limit the upper ranges here in AUM, and I have done that, it's still ending up with all of the faders all being at that upper level at the same time, and it just doesn't sound good. So really, you would need something here, a little adjustment in the UI. I mean, it's probably not going to happen, I'd imagine, but I would really like that. But this elastic mode is really nice to use. And so here I've just switched it over to the draw mode version. But in general, I prefer this on the elastic one, where you just sort of pull up and then some of the nearby faders get pulled up a little bit as well. So again, you know, if you look at fundamental here, those sliders are not going up near the top just because I have capped them in here. So let's just look at the way to set this up. It's going to be different in different hosts. The way I've got it set up here, let me just go back out there again. So up at the top of the AUV3, you want to send that MIDI to, click on this, go in here, choose Skulptur as a MIDI control source. So I've done that here. And then just go in and assign. You know, the easiest way to assign things in AUM is tapping this little knob and then just getting a slider that you want to control. Let's just say this one, even though I don't really want to do that, and just tap it or drag it and it'll pop up. And then you can either press learn, but that's not really ideal for this kind of thing, because you maybe got a bunch of different values going out. So let's just change this to channel 1. And then here, Skulptur sends out MIDI CC 100 to 109. So let me just type in 100 here. And I just press done. And there we go. Now that first slider is moving that one. You can see other things moving because I've set a few things up to respond to that CC message, including something in here as well. But really, very, very nice, very nice. I won't bother using the cycles feature. It depends, you know. Some things you won't need to worry about that upper limit and stuff. But I'd certainly use this a lot in the elastic mode, and probably most of all in the faders mode. So also nice just, you know, you can just like toggle between min and max like that. I just tap in those minimum and maximum buttons. Look, yeah, this is beautiful. Just go in and press these random things. Oh, yeah. I'm also controlling Ringatron here a little bit as well. Controlling six different parameters in that. Again, easiest way, you know, you can start moving things manually. So just like take here and just flick slowly to get something moving slowly, or flick quickly. Whoops, what happened there? There we go, I don't know. So we can get things moving at the speed we want by just dragging at different intensities. And then a little tip, although there's no global control to speed individual sliders down like there is in strips, and that's one of the really nice, there's no individual control to slow things down like there is in SQSL strips, which is one of the really nice features of that app. You've got a rate slider for every one of the main sliders. Plus that has a lot more banks, by the way. I do highly recommend, if you like MIDI CC, go and check out the video I did on that a few days ago, if you haven't watched it yet. But yeah, the quick way to slow things down in this is just pull up the friction slider a bit until things slow down, and then just pull friction down again. And that's if you don't want them to stop entirely. If you do want them to stop after a while, then just, you know, pull friction up higher and eventually they'll all stop. And then you can, you know, bump again if you want and just adjust the friction amount to taste. So this update has a few other features. I haven't checked out any of the other ones yet. You can read about the update in the App Store. I just wanted to show you this, and if it was useful and if you enjoyed it, please smash the like, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Take it easy.